Good evening. Thank you for joining us again in worship this day. We pray you're blessed this day in your worship here in the building, and those of you who are worshiping with us at home, we also pray that you are blessed in your worship of Jesus with us this day. As always, everything you need to know projected behind me here on our wall. We're continuing our Psalm 23 walkthrough, looking at verse 3 today, this Lenten season, and we'll be sharing a time of song at the end of our worship service. That's it for our service notes, so I pray God bless each of you as you worship Him this night. I invite you to stand. Friends, we begin our worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is the day which the Lord has made. From the rising of the sun to its setting, return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful. Jesus said, "If any man would come after me, Christ was wounded for our transgressions. From the rising of the sun to its setting,
the name
of the Lord is to be praised. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen." I invite you now to join me as we take a moment to go to our Lord in silence, bringing all those sins we know and those sins we don't know before God our Father. And then now together we cry out to our Lord. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Now, friends, Almighty God in His mercy has given His Son to die for you, and for His sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by His authority, I therefore forgive you of all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous one. Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. We have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous one. Would you please be seated? Our first reading today comes from Psalm 23. Verse 3, He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for His name's sake. This is the word of the Lord. Second reading comes from Isaiah 49. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor I have answered you. In a day of salvation I have helped you. They shall not hunger or thirst, neither scorching wind nor sun shall strike them. For he who has pity on them will lead them, and by springs of water will guide them. This is the word of the Lord. Friends, grace, peace, and mercy be to each of you from God our Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So tonight we continue to work our way through Psalm 23, verse by verse. And tonight we stop and we pause to look at verse 3. But to change things up a bit, we're going to read through it like a telegram that is being sent. So first we have to stop and pray. God, you are good. Your love, mercy, and forgiveness. You are our good shepherd who is always there for us. Father, as we dig further into your word this night, into this most beautiful psalm, we pray that you send your Holy Spirit upon this place. Into my heart, so my words may be your words, and into the hearts of these, your children gathered here, and those gathered around their TVs at home, that they may be blessed by you in the work that you do in them through the love of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. All right, so here we go. Psalm 23, verse 3, telegram style. The Lord is my shepherd. Stop. It's personal. We keep coming back to this point every week. The Lord is my shepherd. I'm hammering it home in your mind as much as I'm hammering it home in my mind and in our hearts together, because each day we do life, it is tough. It's tough, no matter our age, no matter spiritual maturity, no matter what, every day is a struggle. And every day, it's an opportunity to remind ourselves that the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord. Remember him? That there's only one. Not you, not me, not anyone, not anything. The Lord is the one, the only one who always has been and always will be. And this is important to remember again as we look at the start of verse 3. So the Lord is my shepherd. Now verse 3 says, he restores my soul. Stop. Notice the placement of these words. They follow right after what we talked about last week. The green pastures that feed us. The still waters that refresh us. Those things point us to the Word, right? Back to the Word, to God's Word of love and grace, to His words of forgiveness. And get this, this is what your soul needs. This is what my soul needs. The Lord, who is my shepherd, restores my soul. How? Well, in the Good Shepherd, what do you find? You find a call to come to Him. Matthew 11, 28. The Good Shepherd, Jesus says, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. The Lord, who is my shepherd, restores my soul. You who are broken and hurt, the Good Shepherd restores your soul. You who are suffering and need healing, The Good Shepherd restores your soul. You who are on the outside looking in, the Good Shepherd restores your soul. You who are struggling in your sin, the Good Shepherd restores your soul. You who maybe are paying the price for your sin, the Good Shepherd restores your soul. You who are constantly walking down the wrong road, hand in hand with your sin, the Good Shepherd restores your soul. Jesus says, "Come to me." And the Lord, who is my shepherd, restores the soul. He restores your soul. And he restores your soul and mine nowhere else except at the foot of the cross. You see, the place where the Good Shepherd, Jesus Christ, hung on a tree for you and me, he hung there so that your soul can be restored by him, by his love, by his grace. The Lord is my shepherd. He restores my soul. But there's more to this verse. Continues on. The Lord is my shepherd. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Or, he leads me along the right path for his name's sake. Stop. I want to start off by looking at the second translation of that verse. He leads me along the right path for his name's sake. By ourselves as sheep, what do we do? Right? We go this way and this way. We go astray. We're not smart. There's no righteous act in us. In no way can we follow the right path for his name's sake. The shepherd, right? The shepherd, a good shepherd, not the good shepherd, but a good shepherd leads his flock on the right path, correct? That is going to bring those sheep safely to the next green pasture. Next, to the quiet, still waters. A good shepherd leads his flock continuously on the right path to the proper destination. And that's what the Lord does. That's what God does with the good shepherd. So if the Lord, who is my shepherd, does this for Israel, like we saw in Isaiah chapter 49, he does it for you and me. Now, in that reading from Isaiah, what we have happening here is a picture of restoration being painted. Of God's people being restored, being returned to God's favor by the servant. But not just any servant, by the suffering servant who came along as an atoning sacrifice. Through this sacrifice, God extended favor to and salvation to the people of Israel. Through this same suffering servant, he extended favor to and salvation to you and me, his people. You see, we can't go down the right paths by ourselves. You tried it? I have. We stray, we wander, we lose sight of what path is best. So God, knowing this, sends help. He actually sends his helper, the Holy Spirit. He sends the Holy Spirit to guide us as we strive daily to follow the Good Shepherd, who leads us where? To lie down in green pastures, who gives us a drink of still waters, who restores our soul. And where does he lead us every day? Back to his word, his truth, his love, his grace in his word. Over and over and over again, we see that this path that the Holy Spirit has us on continuously points us back to Christ, the Good Shepherd. He leads us along the right path for his name's sake. You know it well, right? From God, through Christ, to me. From God, through Christ, to you. This, my friends, is the only right path. It's the only path, the only safe passageway from the rocky hills of this life. The only way through those valley lows. The only way to the safe retreat in our heavenly home is from God through Christ to you. For you see, friends, Jesus himself is the way. Jesus himself is the righteous path. There is no other way. There is no other path out there that leads you safely home to be with the Father. It is only through Jesus Christ. It's not found in some New Age religion. It's not found in some pyramid scheme. It's not some enlightenment that you can achieve. No, Jesus himself is the way, the truth, and the life. I'm not making this up. John 14:6. Jesus himself is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through him. Here in this most sacred season of Lent, God is calling you and me back to him, to return to him now. And understand this, he does not just want some piece of you, some outward display, some torn garments here or there, and a few minutes tossed to him once a week. No, he wants you, and he wants your heart. And I know what that heart looks like because I'm right there with you. It's a heart that is slit and torn open. Along the paths of life. It's a heart that's been wounded and damaged and broken through the rocky climb you've been on. But such a heart, friends, God receives from you as a pleasing sacrifice. When you and I, when we cry out to him, realizing that we have wandered from his love, he is still there. He is not left. He is still there restoring you and inviting you to once again follow him down the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Tonight, Lent is for you and me. It's for real, honest to God sinners who have failed in their love of God, who have failed in their love of their neighbor, who have walked the wrong path. It's for honest to God sinners who see this reality and who, by God's grace, despise their sin and ache for his forgiveness and the strength to do better. Look at the cross and you can see. The one who chose you. He is the one who knew that we on our own could not come to him, return to him, or find him. So he came to us. He returned to us. He found us. Look and see and marvel at how far he went. He chose to be one of us. For it's a wonder that blows the mind that the God of Israel, Yahweh himself, should come and take on flesh and blood, as he did in the incarnation. That by itself is enough to leave us astounded forever. But he went further, didn't he? Not only did he take on our flesh and blood, not only did he become dust for us, but he also went as far to lift off from us the burden of our sin. Let that sink in. And he bared it on his own body to death. He did it to own all our failures, all our wrong turns. He did it to love us as his very own. Paul hits a home run once again with his words from 2 Corinthians 5, where he said, "He who knew no sin became sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God." The Lord is my shepherd. Stop. I shall not want. Stop. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Stop. He leads me beside still waters. Stop. He restores my soul. Stop. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Stop. The telegram is out. It's sent. The path is clear. The good shepherd who is my shepherd searches for me, searches for you, feeds me, feeds you, restores me, restores you. Oh, and by the way, he loves you and he loves me. And in this truth, we take great comfort, as it is solely a gift from God through Christ to me and to you all of our days. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. And now may the peace that passes all understanding keep our hearts and minds focused on our Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I invite you to stand now, friends, and join me as we make confession of the Christian faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. I invite you to join me now as we go to our Lord in a time of prayer. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the gift of divine peace and of pardon, with all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord. For the Holy Christian Church, here and scattered throughout the world, and for the proclamation of the gospel and the calling of all to faith, let us pray to the Lord. For this nation, for our cities and communities, and for the common welfare of us all, let us pray to the Lord. For seasonable weather, for the fruitfulness of the earth, let us pray to the Lord. For those who labor, for those whose work is difficult or dangerous, and for all who travel, let us pray to the Lord. For all those in need, for the hungry and homeless, for the widowed and orphaned, and for all those in prison, let us pray to the Lord. For the sick, especially this day, we lift up to you, Lord, Sam and Melissa and Don, EJ and Trina, and Barbara and Don, and Pastor Jones and Dan Kirk, and just finding out Mary Ann Gilbertson. Lord, we place each of these, your children, in your hands and ask that you be with them, provide them the healing that they need. Father, we also pray for the dying and for all those who care for these, your children. Let us pray to the Lord. Father, we pray for all those who do not know you, who do not know that their soul is restored in you. Those that do not know forgiveness and grace, love and mercy that comes through your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray, Father, that you work on their hearts so that they come to know this saving truth, that no matter what path they are on, the only path that leads to you, that leads to our heavenly home, is through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Move them in a good time, in your time, Lord, to come and know this truth so they may celebrate with all of us. Father, we ask this as we pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Now finally, for these and for all our needs of body and soul, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Visit our dwellings, O Lord, and drive from them all the snares of the enemy. Let your holy angels dwell with us to preserve us in peace, and let your blessing be on us always, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Friends, let us bless the Lord. The Almighty and Merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless and preserve you. Amen. I invite you to join me now as we turn Mass to face to sing our hymn, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Have a seat, friends. Thank you so much. What a blessing that is. Muted voices and all. I don't know if you'd be able to pick up on it at home, but we had some nice 3, maybe even 4-part harmony happening throughout that song. So what a blessing to be part of that and hear that. So thank you for sharing your gifts. As always, we do pray you were blessed in your worship of Jesus with us today. We're going to do this again next week, same time, 6:30. We're going to look at a different verse, though. We're going to move on to a verse that most of you probably know from Psalm 23, verse 4. Even though I walk through the valley, the shadow of death. We'll be looking at that one next week. That's it. So God's richest blessings to you as you step out knowing who goes with you along that path and who leads you, your Lord, your Savior, Jesus Christ. Our ushers will let you out from back to front. God's blessings, friends.